TryAdaptLearn. In this video, we will take a quick look inside a 12-volt, 4-pole starter solenoid. If you haven't already subscribed, don't forget to subscribe now for more videos including DIY, maintenance, projects, and yard work. Starter solenoids help to make starting an engine very convenient. Before we take a look inside this 4-pole starter solenoid, we'll take a moment to talk about how they work. As seen, this diagram shows a simple electrical circuit of how the starter solenoid can work. Although this diagram may not use standard symbols, I'm sharing it to help illustrate how the parts function. While we look at this simplified circuit for the starter solenoid, we will start with some vocabulary. Please keep in mind that for this video, we will keep the vocabulary and explanation simple. As mentioned in a previous video, a switch can be used to open and close an electrical circuit. For circuits with a lot of electrical current, a relay can be used. Instead of passing high current through a switch, a relay can make use of a low current switch to help open and close a circuit with high current. A solenoid can include a coil winding such as copper to produce a magnetic field with electrical current. So for this video, when we are talking about a starter solenoid, we are describing a part assembly that contains a solenoid and functions like a relay. Depending on the manufacturer or the retailer, they can also use terms like pole, post, or terminal to describe the amount of electrical connections that can be made to the starter solenoid. The starter solenoid in this video is independent and mounted separately from the starter motor. The purpose of the starter solenoid is to transfer the current from the battery to the starter motor. Rather than send all that current through a switch such as an ignition switch, the assembly uses that switch by working like a relay. And how it does it is because the solenoid inside the assembly will create its own magnetic field that will pull a momentary switch to close the circuit. When the switch is open, the solenoid will lose its magnetism and the momentary switch will then open as well. Notice the pole, post, or terminal labeled as I. This is an optional pole that is meant to provide current to some ignition coils or ballast resistors depending on the ignition setup. We also notice that the 4-pole starter solenoid has no extra pole specific to the ground of the solenoid, which in turn would be grounded to the vehicle chassis on a standard 12-volt negative ground system. We will now do continuity tests with the electrical multimeter. As seen, when the two leads touch or there is continuity, the value on the meter will change. So from these tests, we can see the continuity between the S pole and the mounting bracket that would be connected to the end of the solenoid coil. All other poles do not have continuity because the circuit is not closed with an electrical current. We will then remove the rivets around the bottom plate with a rotary tool. Once the rivets around the bottom plate are removed, the plate will be free. We can see the plate has material on it, not only to form a gasket, but also to act as an insulator from the momentary switch, which looks like a big washer connected to a cylinder shape. We can also see there are springs connected to the bottom of the momentary switch that hold it in place and then return it into position. From this view, we can see how the ignition coil pole is connected to the bottom of the switch. When loosening the eye pole, the momentary switch will fall free. We can then see the inside of the assembly. Again, we can see how the springs hold the momentary switch in place and return it into position. We can also see the wire from the S terminal connected to the end of the actual solenoid coil winding. Once we got the solenoid coil loose, we can see that the second wire is connected to the top metal piece in the assembly, which is then assembled together with the mounting bracket. This connection to the top of the case rather than an additional pole is what makes the 4-pole starter solenoid unique. It is again what allows the solenoid coil to be grounded through the chassis rather than to have an additional ground wire. By squeezing the momentary switch with the springs, we can see the motion that happens when the solenoid coil becomes an electromagnet. It attracts the momentary switch upward into position. So although this video and content is very similar to the 5-pole starter solenoid video, I still wanted to include it because the 4-pole may be more common. I also wanted to show exactly what was different from the inside view. These starter solenoids are common in older 12-volt automotive vehicles. As I make new videos, I want to share them with you, so subscribe now. Also comment, like, and check out some of the other content on our channel.